Hey guys, Corky here with the new Moonkin Guide. I will give you guys an update on the currently best comps, Azerite trades, stats and much more. Let's start with looking at the best comps for Moonkins. There's a lot of good comps that we can play in the current meta, and it is actually quite hard to determine which the best is, since it depends on the matchup you're playing. So don't stress about playing the best comp. If you want to play with a caster, you can play several comps. Frostmage Moonkin Resto Shaman is just a great comp to not only dampen most teams, but also deal crazy burst damage with a combination of Moonkin Aura and Arcane Intellect. Shadow Priest Moonkin Resto Shaman is quite similar to the Frostmage version, just with more instant CC and higher sustained damage, which allows to rot down a melee team way faster. Elemental Shaman Moonkin Resto Shaman is a comp that can be really crazy with Earthshock stuns into Star Surges combined with off-healing. If you want to play with a melee, you can go with two comps right now. DH Moonkin with a Mistweaver Monk or Resto Shaman is a setup based comp that really focuses on killing in stuns and CCing the healer. Red Pada Moonkin Resto Shaman is the most aggressive Moonkin comp, with Hodge being the enabler for CC chains. Really fun and fast-paced gameplay. As I said, these comps are all good, but my favorite right now is Frostmage Moonkin Resto Shaman, because it is the most fun to play in this melee meta on EU. Now let's go over Azerite trades and what changed in the last few weeks. As you guys probably already know, Streaking Stars got nerfed by 50% in PvP, which means it is not a viable damage trade to play. However, recently by playing in a tournament setting, I found out that it is often not even good to go for damage trades as a Moonkin, and here's why. If you get tunneled as a Moonkin, you're pretty much forced to go bear form and toss out as many cyclones as you can, which gets really annoying and stops you from doing damage. Now what you can do is actually play defensive Azerite trades to prevent you from this playstyle. So optimally, you should have two sets of gear when it comes to Azerite trades. One set that is aiming to deal the most possible damage for arena games, where you know that you will not be the target or not being tunneled by melee. And one full defensive set for games where you 100% know that you will get tunneled and need the extra defensive traits. All of the offensive traits are purely single target damage increase over a certain time, and it does not really matter if you stack them or not. They still go by the same order. Thunderous Blast, Laser Matrix, Archive of the Titan, and Dagger in the Back. Now what has to be mentioned is that Dagger in the Back is extremely nice against stealth classes to have that extra dot on them which cannot be dispelled. Here you can see that the Druid is trying to dispel his dots to get a drink off because he is on low mana, but then realizes he still has the Dagger in the Back dot on him. So he decides to just innovate. It also is insane in dampening games, where the enemy healer is always trying to look for a drink. The dot can keep them in combat and make it unable for them to get a clean drink off. Also, the stacking of traits does not increase their chance of proccing. There is a bleed spec you could run as a Moonkin, where you go for all bleed traits and a slow trade. You would go for Dagger in the Back, Rezan's Fury, and Tidal Surge. This spec could be really nice in long dampening games as a spell cleave. For other trades, it does not matter too much what you pick, since the impact is not as big. However, you can just go by PvE sims, as long as they make sense for PvP. For example, Overwhelming Power is the best tier 2 trade for PvE, but has the effect that you lose value of it once you take damage, which constantly happens in arena. For the defensive traits, there are mainly two traits you should aim for. But keep in mind that these traits have to be stacked compared to the offensive traits. This is because they do not have a chance of proccing, but enhance your defensive cooldown bark skin. Urshock's Endurance is great against melees and casters to really make bark skin a viable defensive cooldown. Craggy Bark can only be used against melees, preferably two of them, to really get use out of it. For tier 2 and tier 3, there are several traits which are nice to enhance your tankiness. Examples here would be Azerite Veins, or resounding protection. Moonkins have three main tasks in Arena, which are damage, control, and support. Your job, no matter what comp you play, is to balance these out. Obviously, a main part of playing Moonkin is to deal as much damage as possible, and especially in the right moments. So you will find yourself in scenarios where you want to maximize your AoE damage because you are playing a comp that rots down the enemy team like Shadow Priest Moonkin or Frostmage Moonkin. As you can see, I don't lose my focus on the goal, which is rotting the team, so I keep redotting as much as I can to really ensure we will not lose the pressure. On the other hand, when you are playing comps like DH Moonkin or Red Moonkin, you want to save your damage and only do single target damage in setups. So keep in mind that your damage will always look different depending on what comp you are playing. Dealing AoE pressure as a Moonkin is really straightforward. 50% of your damage is literally through Moon and Sunfire, so always keep them up on as many targets as you can. A key to spreading the most damage is to actually hit the healer whenever you can with Star Surges and Dot Uptime. Here you can see how I decide to hit the Priest instead of the DPS, to force him to heal himself first. This allows my Shadow Priest to rot down the melees and keep the pressure rolling. Notice I keep my dots up on all targets though. This ensures that he ooms faster, since he also has to heal himself, and especially in this Resto Druid and Disc Priest meta, it is quite effective. Keep in mind that you will never use Starfall unless you are trying to get out stealth classes. Sadly, all single target spells do not really deal noticeable damage. Your main single target damage consists of keeping up dots on the target you want to hit and using Star Surges combined with Lunar Strike procs. As you can see in this clip, I am sitting Bareform till an opportunity opens to really deal decent damage with Star Surge. Me casting Solar Wrath or Lunar Strike in Moonkin form would have done nothing. If you have free time to hardcast, just make sure that you only cast empowered Lunar Strikes or empowered Solar Wraths, since without the buff they are really worthless. The so-called secret with dealing decent single target damage is to save enough Astral Power to Star Surge twice and managing your empowerments. This means you should not waste empowerment stacks and rotate between Lunar Strike and Solar Wrath when casting to use all your empowerments. With the Streaking Stars nerf and Incarnation being on a 3-minute CD with a GCD, Moonkin Burst really is not as strong as it used to be. Keep in mind though that Incarnation becomes exponentially stronger in Dampening, since it opens up pressure windows to force cooldowns. The best tip here is to never pop Incarnation in a bad position where it is easy for the enemy to line or without you getting CC on the healer or a stun on the target you want to hit. In this scenario I get stunned, which means the next stuns on me will be DR'd, so my Incarnation can't be stopped as good. In addition to that, all enemies are on my line and I have a bash ready to CC. So I decide to pop my Incarnation, which ends up pressuring the team. Now Moonkin brings a lot of control into a 3v3 match and can decide over the pace of the game if he uses his tools properly. Cyclone is your biggest tool to do so. This is arguably one of the greatest CCs in the game and can be either used to control offensive cooldowns of enemies or to prevent defensive cooldowns by cloning them. Currently what you will see most good Moonkins do is just toss out dots on the enemies while spamming as many Cyclones as possible and rotate them on the enemies while saving up their Star Surges to burst. In this clip, you can see how great it can be to cyclone targets on low health to deny incoming healing. In addition to clone, you can also pick Mighty Bash as a talent to have an extra stun. This can just like clone be used defensive but also offensive to actually kill someone in a bash. This clip from the beginning is a really nice showcase of how great Mighty Bash can be. In this case, it allowed us to follow up the stun chain by the elemental to secure the kill. Even though the Shadow Priest swaps the rested druid, the pressure and the long stun chain we have going on cannot be stopped, so this last bash I do prevents the rested druid to recover with going into bear form or swiftment. Another great control tool are your entangling roots. A lot of people underestimate it, but it can be super annoying, especially for melees, to get rooted and then after a dispel instantly get rooted again. Notice it does not share DR with Cyclone, so you can rotate between the two if you really want to annoy a melee. On the other hand, you can also pick Mars Entanglement, which should not be confused with Entangling Roots. This little talent allows you to instantly root enemies in a certain area. If you combine that with your Solar Beam, you can instantly create an 8-second CC on the healer. Just a great combo to pressure the enemy team, get possible kills and also stop enemy pressure. Here you can see that I cloned a Shaman on Dispel. And then follow it up with a full Mars Root and Beam combo to seal the deal. The last task for a Moonkin is to support his team. Moonkins are hybrids and can decide over a game if they support at the right times. The control part we just talked about already is kind of a support, since it relieves pressure from your team. But you also have some nice support with heals and dispels. Remove Corruption allows you to remove all curses and poisons. You can support your team by using Dispel to take less damage. Dispelling Agony or Curses from Warlocks would be a great example. In addition to that, you can dispel hexes from your teammates, which completely denies an 8-second CC. The greatest support in BFA is your healing though. You have great off heals with regrowth and you should always try to use them if you need to support your healer with topping the team. Restoration Affinity is also really nice if you want to play in an even more supportive playstyle. Here you have the instant big heal Swiftment to help your teammates in dangerous situations and Rejuvenation as a HOT. So that's going to wrap up this guide. I hope you guys liked it and keep in mind that everything can change in the next few weeks, so keep up with the latest Moonkin changes.